Okay, so I figured I'd make a video on how to use my MIDI to clone hero converter. All of the keyboard shortcuts and info on how to use this are in the README on GitHub. This video will probably be outdated fairly soon because I make updates fairly regularly and add features, but it should give a basis for how to start. So if you go to this page, you can load in a MIDI. I'm going to be converting Invention 1 by Johann Sebastian Bach, and this MIDI happens to already have the left hand and the right hand split into two different tracks, so I don't have to worry about that. But if that weren't the case, then I'd have to go in, select these, and then move them to whatever track. But they do have them as grand piano, and I'm gonna want them to be harpsichord. So now that I have them as harpsichord, I'll be able to generate the OGG audio file, because that's not generated by my converter. You have to do that separately. This goes over all the keyboard shortcuts and how to use it. You can click and drag to move around, up arrow, down arrow to move just a little bit. Plus will increase how much that is, so I'm moving a lot. Down arrow will decrease how much that is, or not down arrow, a minus. Now I can do find stuff. The D button, in the event of a chord, will, when you go over a note, delete the lower of the notes. And then you can Z to undo, Y to redo, L to reload. If I press play, it also deletes it. Backspace will delete the top of the notes in a chord. If there's no chord, it just deletes the note. Then Z to undo. And the delete button will delete all the notes. And that will affect how it chooses what frets to use. You can choose to have extended sustain, so you have something like this green happens while this yellow is being sustained, or you can disable that and it won't allow that to happen. You can change how long the minimum sustain is, so if you have it at zero, it'll have lots of mini sustains. You can change what the sustain gap is, so if there's a zero sustain gap, it'll have them go all the way to the next note if that's what the MIDI says. If you have it 0.125, it'll be a little bit. Generally use 2.5, then a minimum sustain of 0.5, and those are in beats. The ignore gap is how many seconds between notes that it stops carrying, what fret it's using. Yeah, so it groups the notes by how far apart they are. It won't group notes that are more than a certain amount apart with no notes in between. Note tolerance is just for with the extended sustains on, when it checks if a note ends at the same time as another. So this extend goes past this note, and so if I made the note tolerance a bit larger, it would think, oh hey, this note ends at the same time as this one, I should put a sustain gap. But if I have it low, like this, then it's too far away for it to think that this is the same. For leading silence, that's just how many seconds of leading silence. Zero means no leading silence, but generally good to have some leading silence. Scale is just the view on how many seconds you can see at once. If you have 10, you can see 10 seconds worth and scroll slowly. I generally use 2. Then you can choose which tracks you want to be part of. And in the audio playback, it doesn't care what instrument it is, it's just a simple tone. And it will only play notes for what's on the chart. So if you hear there's a note missing, it's probably on a different track that's not enabled. So now if I disable the top track, you can only hear the bass. And then when you export, you can only export one chart at a time. And then number of frets, just like 3 makes it like an easy chart for like a medium. if I have like a hard and expert. If I have the max BPS, beats per second, low, like 5, it will ignore fast stuff. If I have it like 10, it will ignore this trill. I find 30 to be good. Gonna download that, and then go to the base, and download this one separately, and extract them. Then to make it into just one chart, take one of them, then these are the different things you can have it as. It can be an expert, hard, medium, easy chart on the single, double guitar, double bass, double rhythm, keyboard, and then all the stuff in between the curly braces are just the note data. So the time, and if it's a note, then what fret it is and how long it is. Don't need to know that. But. So I'm gonna have this one be not expert single, but expert double bass. Then I no longer need this. And append it to the end of this one. I no longer need that. You have to make the audio track separately. It'll try and take the name of the song and stuff like that out of the MIDI, but in this case it's not in the MIDI, so I have to specify that the name of this is invention number 1 C major BWV 772, the artist Johann Sebastian Bach. Say the album is Inventions, genre classical, year like 1678. You can change the loading phrase. So that should be good. Then you'll need to create your OOG and then generate your silence. 2 seconds of silence at the beginning of your OOG. I already have done that. Drop it in. Then I can open this in Moonscraper. Rename the audio to song.oog. Now I got audio. Because I generated the audio from the MIDI, it's perfectly in time. This conveniently doesn't have any tempo changes, but some songs from MIDIs will have plenty of tempo changes, and it'll account for that and put them all in, and it'll be great. Unless you're using audio from a recording, in which case you have to tempo map it to the recording, which can be a pain. If I go to the bass is all nice. And I noticed I used 3 notes. So, if I go in, might want to use 5. Make this expert double bass. So now it's on 5 notes. Nice. Make them all tap. Beautiful. Save that. Going to clone here. Scan songs. Now I've got invention number one. You can play it. Ah, so sad. Minus two. That's it.